Hello and welcome to VNatomy, veterinary anatomy and physiology for students studying veterinary nursing and animal science. The focus of today's video is the thoracic cavity. Using the dog as an example, we will outline the boundaries of this cavity, its main contents, the additional cavities, and the serosal linings. The thoracic cavity is surrounded by the bony supports of the ribs, thoracic vertebrae, and sternum. The cranial border of the thoracic cavity is marked by an area called the thoracic inlet. You can think of this like a ring made up of the first thoracic vertebra, the first pair of ribs, and the first sternebra, the manubrium. You can palpate or feel the manubrium, so this is a good landmark to be able to locate when doing thoracic radiographs to ensure you have the entire lung field on the film. The dorsal border is made up of the thoracic vertebrae and the hypaxia muscles, which sit below them. The caudal border to this cavity is the diaphragm. Any structures which continue through into the abdomen must pass through spaces in the diaphragm. The diaphragm is attached to the lumbar vertebrae, caudal ribs, and sternum. To locate the caudal part of the thoracic cavity, you can palpate the 12th and 13th ribs and the last sternebra, known as the xiphoid process or xiphisternum. The ventral border is marked by the sternum. The lateral borders, which are not shown on this section through the sagittal plane, would be the ribs and the intercostal muscles between them. The main organs contained within the thoracic cavity are the heart and the lungs. Let's look at a dorsal section and a transverse section to better examine the smaller cavities within the main thoracic cavity, the pleural cavities, mediastinum, and pericardial cavity, as well as the membranes that line them. The left and right pleural cavities contain the left and right lungs respectively. The serosal membrane or mesothelium lining the lungs and thoracic cavity is known as the pleura. The visceral pleura adheres closely to the lungs. The parietal pleura lines the inside of the thoracic cavity and it will be named according to the area it covers. For example, the diaphragmatic pleura coats the diaphragm and the costal pleura covers the inside of the ribs and intercostal muscles. There is a potential space between the visceral and parietal pleura known as the pleural space. The serosa will secrete small amounts of fluid which help to lubricate and allow movement of the lungs against the thoracic wall during breathing. In the centre of the thorax, between the two pleural cavities, lies a potential space called the mediastinum. It is bounded by the parietal pleura from the left and right sides, known as the mediastinal pleura. Suspended within the mediastinum are various structures, including the heart, trachea, esophagus, and thymus. Blood vessels, including the aorta and vena cava, will also travel through this area, as well as major nerves and lymphatic vessels. The heart is also covered with serosal membranes, known as the pericardium. So, within the mediastinum, there is also the pericardial cavity containing the heart. Between the visceral and parietal pericardium, there's a small amount of pericardial fluid. This will allow the heart to beat freely. In life, these cavities are filled with organs and a small amount of fluid. This is why they are known as potential spaces. In some disease states, these cavities can fill with fluid or air. If this happened, what would happen to the organs inside? In the case of a pneumothorax, air enters the pleural space, which can compress or even collapse the lung, leading to difficulty breathing or dyspnea. You should now have a better understanding of the structure of the thorax and the cavities within. Try to practice palpating some of the landmarks in a dog or cat to help positioning for thoracic radiographs. The next time you see a patient with thoracic disease, think about which cavity is affected. Please leave a comment if you have any further questions. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to see future videos. Thanks for watching.